Greetings everyone, my name is Rob Griffiths, I'm a senior editor at Macworld, and on this installment of the Macworld video blog, I thought I'd do something a little different than the typical OS X productivity tip. As some of you may know, in addition to my OS X work, I also look at virtualization solutions for running things like Linux and Windows on your Intel-powered Mac. Now I'm sure all of you are familiar with both Parallels Desktop for Mac and VMware's Fusion. But there's a third player in the market that just recently came out, and it's from Sun, and it's called VirtualBox. And the main difference between VirtualBox and the other two competitors is that VirtualBox is free. That's right, completely free. It's actually based on an open source project, and you can download it yourself for free today. I thought I would spend a few minutes showing you how it works and demonstrating how it performs and some of the things you can do with it. So let's go ahead and get started. Obviously, the first thing you need to do is to download and install VirtualBox. And to do that, we'll just go to www.virtualbox.org, which is Sun's website for the VirtualBox program, and we'll click on the Downloads button to download the application. Once you've downloaded it, it's a simple installer, answer a couple of questions, and the program is installed, and you'll have this nice 512-pixel OS X icon available if you'd like it. When you launch the program, you see an interface that's quite familiar if you've ever used Parallels or Fusion. Across the top, we have some buttons. Down the side, we have a list of the installed virtual machines. And off to the right, there are three tabs showing details, save snapshots, and a description of the VM. Let's take a look at how you actually install an operating system. In this case, OpenSolaris, which is a free version of Solaris available at opensolaris.com. First thing you have to do is download the ISO, which is the disk image containing the operating system. Now, we've sped things up a bit here. This is a 686 megabyte file, but once you've downloaded the ISO, all you need to do to install it is click the New button in VirtualBox. That'll start the wizard, which walks you through the installation process. In the wizard, we just click the Next button, and we name our operating system. In this case, I'll call it OpenSolaris, and use the OS Type button to choose the operating system. You can't see it on the screen, but I selected OpenSolaris. Then I click the Next button, and that takes me to the next screen, where we're going to set up the system's memory. We'll leave it at 512 meg, and now we need a hard drive. And you click the New button and just kind of follow the steps through, dynamically expanding image. I want to make mine about 10 gigabytes instead of 16. So I'll move the slider around until I get to 10 gigabytes and then I'll hit Next. And then I'm done with the drive, so I hit Finish. It takes me back to this screen. I just check that there's a new disk. I can hit Next and Finish again. And that's it. I've now created the virtual machine. To install the operating system on the virtual machine, I simply click the Start button in the VirtualBox interface, and that will launch a wizard that walks me through the OS installation process. Here you can see the wizard's first screen. I'll click the Next button, and this brings up a screen where you tell the machine how to boot. We're going to use the image file we downloaded, but we have to tell the system where it is. To do that, we click the folder icon on the right, which brings up this dialog box, and you click the Add button. From there, you'll see the OS X file navigation dialog, find the ISO file and click OK, and it will then appear in the list. Select it, and then click Select, and that will start the installation process with that ISO image. So here you can see the splash screen for OpenSolaris. From here, I actually selected that and then just followed the OpenSolaris installation instructions, and a few minutes later, I had a fully functional OpenSolaris installation running inside of VirtualBox. It's just that simple. It took about 7 minutes. So much for installing an operating system. What about using one? I thought I'd take a couple minutes and show you Windows XP Pro running inside VirtualBox to demonstrate both the performance and some of the VirtualBox features. So here we have XP Pro running, and you can see there's a full screen mode as well as a seamless mode. Here's a quick look at full screen mode. It takes over my entire desktop. I can switch back into windowed mode. If I go into seamless mode, you'll see that the windows from OS X are intermingled with the windows from XP Pro. If I bring up some of my windows here, an activity monitor in the browser, you can see that the XP Pro windows are intermixed with the windows from OS X. You can drag them around, you can easily switch from one to another, and you can go back into windowed mode just that easily. Similar to both Parallels Desktop and VMware's Fusion, there's also a set of guest add-ons you can install to make integration of graphics and mouse easier. As you can see here, I can resize the Windows desktop just by dragging and dropping the corner of the window, and it happens in real time. And the mouse switches operating systems as it gets dragged in and out of things. How about performance? Well, here's Microsoft Office 2003. You can see it opens very quickly. And here's a complex document from Office 2003. It's actually an old OS X Solutions guidebook I wrote years ago. It's got a lot of embedded graphics, and as you can see, it scrolls rapidly from top to bottom, and performance in all of my testing seemed just fine. But how about something a little more stressful than simply dragging Windows and running Word? Let's take a look at some video. To test the video quality of VirtualBox, I went to the WMV HD Content Showcase website and downloaded some sample clips. In particular, I thought I would use the fighter pilot clip as it's got some nice visuals and some really nice audio. So I downloaded it, installed Windows Media Player 11, and then set out to test the results. So here's one video clip to watch. Here's that same video clip in another virtualization program.
Sniper 1's Tally 2 ship, off my nose.
Now, can you tell which one came on which virtualization program? Well, here's the answer. The first clip was in Fusion, and the second clip was in VirtualBox. To me, the performance differences between the two programs were indistinguishable. Both did great. Sun's VirtualBox has more features than I've had time to demonstrate here today. It has a wide variety of supported guest operating systems, it has support for shared folders, it can emulate a SATA hard drive, it supports hyperthreading, and more. There are a couple things it can't do. It can't use your bootcamp Windows partition as a virtual machine, and you can't use DirectX accelerated graphics, so no 3D gaming in VirtualBox, at least as of yet. But for every other use, including audio and video, it seemed to work just fine. So that's a 5-minute overview of Sun's new VirtualBox virtualization solution for OS X on Intel-powered Macs. We'll have more to say about VirtualBox on Macworld.com in the future, but for now, I hope this video overview has shown you some of the program's capabilities, as well as given you a sense as to how well it performs. From what I've seen so far, it's well worth the download time. Thanks, and until next time, this is Rob Griffiths, signing off for the Macworld video blog.